Hey, yo guys, hold up. I have the greatest idea. Listen to this. One, create my own exchange. Two, farm hot new asset and become the biggest liquidity provider. Three, abruptly pull the rug as a liquidity provider, tanking the price of that coin. Four, in the panic, buy more coins. Five, list the token on my exchange and dump the price. Oh, wait, never mind. Somebody beat me to it. Boy, this place is freaking crazy. What's going on, crypto cousins? It's your Bitcoin baby daddy here with another episode. If you're new here, go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, because I'm making content every other day. Why am I shaking my hand? Or when I feel like it, you know how it goes. Come on. Hey, first and foremost, guys, I want to say shout out to Altcoin Daily for shouting out my video in his, like, what, one of his recent episodes. You know, I'd be taking my time with my videos, so his episode was like maybe 2 days back or whatnot. But shout out to Altcoin Daily for the shout out. What's up, new crypto cousins? Y'all gonna get used to it. If you like me, you'll stick around. If you don't, you'll leave. But it is what it is. Appreciate you guys subbing, commenting, giving me the love. So I gotta take a drink. So today we're gonna be talking about SushiSwap. SushiSwap. I swear to God, I really had it down before I started recording. SushiSwap, there we go. So today we're gonna be talking about SushiSwap, and no, we're not gonna be talking about how the price of Bitcoin is tanking right now, but it's okay, because I stable coined up this morning like I told myself I was going to. Whatever people tell you, hey guys, take profits. Don't listen to them. Don't listen to them saying they're holding on forever. Take profits. Today we're gonna be talking about SushiSwap. It's newest, hottest automated money market. If you don't know what an automated money market is, think about Uniswap, think about Monoswap. That's what SushiSwap is going to be. Well, it's not, it doesn't look like what it's going to be right now, but it's going to be looking like the other two pretty soon. But what is SushiSwap? It's an automated money market, decentralized exchange where people like me or you or anybody in the world can provide liquidity or provide this cryptocurrency, this money, for say, and when I provide that liquidity, other people will trade my token and they'll give me a percentage of the trading fees in ETH for me providing my liquidity for other people to exchange. It's almost literally like, I don't know, being your own bank. So the difference with this one is that it's gonna be a Uniswap with its own token, Sushi. So this is the first time I actually seen somebody talking about a SushiSwap kind of thing, with Larry Cermak saying, what could Uniswap do if some talented dev forks everything, slightly changes the branding, and releases the token that eventually distributes 90% of its supply to its liquidity providers? Uniswap is an absolute beast and has a great team, but what could they do? Now, and he also puts down there, I guess something similar is currently happening with Moonswap, except the token distribution itself is trash. So yes, so if people don't know, Moonswap is actually coming out with their own token. No one's talking about it because right now it's being mined. But the token distribution is not like 90-10 or anything like that. Because, of course, you have, I remember I reported back, Mike Novogratz and Binance and them, they all invested in the Moonswap. So, of course, you know, they got a majority of the Moonswap tokens. And cryptocurrency, like, if you've been in the cryptocurrency space a long time, for a while now, for or at least for the past 3 years, you're tired of all the VCs getting in first. We just entered a phase where we can be first. It's a second ICO phase. And seeing things like that, even the devs, even people that build these kind of apps, don't like that shit. They don't. And they usually don't support it when they see it. So that's why, but of course, people are still farming Moonswap because at the end of the day, not everyone's a good-hearted dev or whatnot. And don't get surprised, but Uniswap also has VC funds behind them as well. And they're more, I guess, the original classy VC funds, whatever, but they're controlled by some fund organization as well. Well, SushiSwap is supposed to be for the people. Air quotes, people. Man, move. people. So with the current Uniswap configuration, 0.3% of all trading fees in any pool is proportionately distributed to the pool liquidity providers. In the SushiSwap, 0.25% of 0.25 go directly to the active liquidity providers, while the remaining 0.05 get converted back into Sushi, obviously through Uniswap, and distributed to the Sushi tokens, Sushi holders. So that's pretty much what they're doing. But for them to actually run, for them to actually raise funds to support this project, you know, because, you know, at the end of the day, nobody's building something for free. We have a tweet right here from Martha right here, and she talks about this whole vampire attack. So what a vampire attack is, essentially what SushiSwap is doing right now to Uniswap. They're basically getting all their people to farm on Uniswap or whatever, or provide liquidity on Uniswap, and then have them take that liquidity and leave with them to their own exchange and whatnot. So a simple vampire attack is to bootstrap your project B. Current project A, with all its open source smart contracts and front end, has no token yet but earns fees on everyday token flow. You implement migration mining for project A to project B. Basically, you give SB the people who migrate liquidity from A to B. You implement the same governance and start sharing revenues with your new token holders for holding SB. Project A has no liquidity and loses all revenue. So essentially, everyone's going to be mining or providing liquidity on Uniswap, and then they're going to take that liquidity and say, hey, you know, claim your tokens over here on SushiSwap, and now you're here with us. So now what can Uniswap do if SushiSwap is giving people an incentive to collect tokens while being a liquidity provider? And like I said, Uniswap is doing the same thing, except, you know, their tokens are more allocated to the founding people instead of giving out to the people. You know what I'm saying? But if we can see what SushiSwap's price is doing, it had a nice little 10x and then and now it's crashing with the rest of the market. But there's a little suspicious going on with this 10x here, right? Because you would think an exchange like this, of course it's going to 10x, of course it's going to go crazy. But for something that's like distributed to a lot of people, you wouldn't think the price would crash so hard. And the reason why I know that is because being in another token that was evenly distributed out to people, the price doesn't crash that hard. It gradually increases over time because nobody is selling. But when you have influencers that have a lot of coins, they can tank the market and easily turn the market in a direction. Saying that, I actually want to come to this tweet right here. And I started this, and I started the conversation out with this tweet. So pretty much DC investor ETH right here is accusing SBF. And for those who don't know who SBF is, he's the CEO of FTX Official, or the FTX Derivatives Exchange. And of course, they're one of the very first exchanges, if not the first exchange, to list SushiSwap on their derivatives exchange. So yeah, so essentially he's accusing them of actually using this tactic of being a liquidity provider and then taking their liquidity out, allowing the price to crash, and then buying back in and putting the liquidity back, getting all the tokens. Because of course, you can see right here, that's when all the liquidity drained out. And yeah, so the moment we hit August 31st, the coins got listed on SBF exchange and just started pumping. Now, when it comes to this coin, when it comes to like the price, I would say the price is going to go back all the way to where it was before the listing. So we're looking at like $3.71, around that area. That's around the time that I feel like I might start putting in my first position, but I really want to see if it can hold this 70 cents, or if anything, if the project even comes out, because right now they don't even have the exchange up. This is just, you know, for you to provide liquidity and whatnot. So that's pretty much what SushiSwap is in a nutshell. Here's some of the shady stuff that might be happening around in the background. Now, and I'm not saying it's happening, but these people are putting it openly on Twitter and I'm just reporting on it. You know what I'm saying? And of course you can see some names says On Chain Never Lies. It was over 3 million. Sushi Boys. Sometimes I love crypto Twitter because crypto Twitter just be calling it out like as they see it, bro. And it's just so savage with it, dog. So savage. But yeah, I think I just talked about everything I wanted to talk about the right way. For people who actually be sticking around for my content. Just so y'all can see the price of Bitcoin and what's going on with it. Did we feel it? Did we feel the CME gap? Oh, I think we filled the CME gap, y'all. I think we filled the CME gap. Or was it at 9,600? But on the derivative exchange. Oh God, bruh, look. The savagery. The savagery. But hey guys, you guys really wanna know something? Wow. If you, it looks like a Bart head. It looks like such a Bart head. People are gonna call this a Bart head immediately. Immediately gonna call this a Bart head. Oh my gosh. Just looking at some indicators, we don't hit oversold on the daily pretty often. You see right here, we hit oversold and stayed under it for maybe a day. And a couple of times back here, you know, we hit the oversold, hit the oversold. But, you know, these were always good. Looking back at it now, if you're holding for the long term, these were always good buying opportunities. Even if you saw it crash down here and do that. Right now, if you bought all these other opportunities of being oversold on the RSI, you'd be up, what, a year later? You'd be up. So just be mindful of that. Just looking out a year later, just, you know, I say, just be mindful of that, guys. Other than that, man, thank you so much for coming back to our channel. I appreciate you guys. Take it easy. Yeah.